Yes, good afternoon everyone. Welcome back. Myself, Dhanashree and Ula. So with respect to our last class, we had come across with three models. Okay, so that was class model, state model, and one more happens to be interaction model. Okay, so with respect to class model, we are coming across with two different diagrams there. That is using UML, that's Unified Modeling Language. So one is class diagram and one more happens to be object diagram there. Okay, so in my last classes also I had said to you, you are firstly identifying objects, okay, that is real world objects. Then what you do is you start collecting those object properties there, okay. So the one which you come across with common properties, common possessing characteristics of the objects, you list them together and you say that this is pertaining to one particular class there, okay. So this is how you are going to identify a class and an object, okay. So here you can just come across with this example. So here a class can be called out as a person, okay, whereas objects are, you can represent using UML, it has been represented as a rectangular box and you write down the class name, okay. So that is one respective name of a class you are giving across, okay. Object diagrams or as objects are being given across with a notification as you will be writing the object name, then colon, then to which class does it pertain, that's to the person as a class, okay. Then here, Mary Sharp, okay, so this is one more object, second object, to a class called out as person, belong to a class called out as person. Else, if at all you are not very particular with the object name, you can just leave it blank and just use colon and person. So this is also how do you notify or give the notifications for objects there. This is for the notification of a class, okay. An object has three characteristics, one is called out as a state, the second one is behavior and then unique identification. Okay, so this is how an object is being identified. Okay, an object is usually, if at all I ask you for a definition for that, an object is a concept, abstraction or thing with identity that has meaning for an application there. For any respective application, so which has a concept, which has an abstraction within it and the thing with identity. Okay, so we call that one as an application. Okay, so that particular thing which defines an application is called as an object there. Okay, what is this class diagram? Class diagram provide a graphical notation for modeling classes and their relationship, thereby describing possible objects there. Okay, so that is how we classify or else we notify this class diagram there. Okay, so conventions or else the respective notations which are used across for a class diagram. Okay, so with respect to your UML. UML, as I said to you, it's for Unified Modeling Language, which is used out for your design purpose there. Okay, so before we are getting across to design, we should get to know that. So whatever we have identified the requirements, okay, from those requirements or specification, we identify objects there. Okay, when we identify objects first, then we identify to which class do they belong. Okay, so how these things are being shown across in an modeling language there. Okay, so that is what we are coming across here. Okay, so objects are modeled using a box. Okay, so with the name followed by colon. Okay, so here you can just come across with an example. It's a rectangular box for me. Okay, so I'll be specially taking it across, dividing this rectangular box into three divisions there. The first is at the top is the class name. The second one happens to be your data types or as the data members there. Then the next section wherein you'll be writing across with the member functions there. Okay, this is a class name, data members. Data members are nothing but the properties which define this particular class. And the third one, the last one, is the operations which you are acting on this particular class. Okay, for this example here it is person. Okay, so properties. So how do you define this class called out as a person? Through a person name. That is, how do I differentiate one object with another object? Is with the name of that particular person, then the birth date, which happens to be a unique one. Okay, so name, I just use a colon as an operator and I say that it's of a string kind of a type or it's a data type which I am expecting. Okay, birth date, I just say that birth date is of a type called out as date there. Okay, these are the data types. Now how do you define int a, int b? Okay, that is nothing but a and b are variables of integer type. So in the same way here, name is an data type of a string type, birth date is an data type of date type. Okay, so this is a class with attributes. Okay, now comes objects. Okay, so objects are always keep in mind. So this is onto the other side, the right hand side of me, it is object diagram, this is class diagram. So as I said you, class diagrams are nothing but skeleton structure of the objects there. Okay, whereas object diagrams are examples for the same. Okay, now whenever I am writing an object diagram, so always keep in mind, you will be writing along with this, what's the object name? Joe Smith: person. So this is the object for me. Okay, what's the second object which I am expecting? Mary Sharp: person. Okay, so these are my two objects now. Okay, so along with that, what's the name here? For these, I'll be giving examples there. Okay, so examples are nothing but object diagram. Name is equals to Joe Smith. Birth date is equals to, okay, 21st October 1983. One more, Mary Sharp. Name is equals to Mary Sharp. Birth date is equals to 16 March 1950. So this is skeleton for me of that class. These are values to those respective objects there. Okay, so always keep in mind, your class names are singular nouns. Okay, whereas the first very letter happens to be capital one. Okay, and whenever you are writing across with the object diagram, always keep in mind, your first letter should be in capital one. Okay, if at all it's a multi word, always keep in mind, multiple words where it starts and ends should be in capitals there. J should be in capital, S should be in capital. Okay, similarly here also. Okay, so this is with your object and this is with your class diagram. Okay, and operation, what do you mean by an operation? Operation is a function or procedure that may be applied to or by objects in a class. Okay, by objects in a class there. Okay, now like for example, if I say person, person can change job, change address. Now these are operations. These are called what as operations now. Okay, so this is my, for any rectangular box, this is the class name, this is the data members, these are member functions. Okay, with respect to this class. Okay, now similar example, I'll just tell you with the file. Okay, file is a class name, file name, size and bytes, last update, these are all, what are these? These are data members. Okay, what is this? This is operation for this particular class called out as file. Okay, similarly, geometric object. Okay, if this is my class name, color, position, these are data members. These are the two properties which define this particular class there. Okay, whereas I have three operations. What are those? Move, select, rotate. Okay, if I say move, okay, I am looking across with a delta type of a variable which is of vector. Okay, p is a variable which I am considering in this argument. Okay, that's of a point type. Okay, and we are expecting the data type to be boolean type. Okay, so similarly, rotate. Okay, in angle. Okay, that is, this is one of the argument for that. Okay, and it is float type which you are expecting. So these three happens to be your class names to you. Okay, these are data members and these are member functions. Okay, this is how a method is being notified. Okay, so similarly, if at all I want to speak regarding summary of notations for classes there. So how do you define it? This is class name. Okay, this is attribute name, that is like if I take person, this is name. Okay, data type is string, is equals to default value. What default value do you want to give to it? Attribute name 2, data type 2, then default value. Okay, so like this you can have multiple number of attributes. Similarly, I will be having arguments here. Okay, so this is for summary of modeling the notations of classes, notation for classes there. Okay, for an operation, whenever you are giving across for an operation, always keep in mind, so this is your direction is your respective operation name. Okay, so this is the argument name, which type is it, which data type is it, then what's the default value for that. Okay, what's the return value which you are expecting for that. So this is how you will be notifying any respective operation. So with respect to your class diagrams, okay, if I want to relate more than one class to one another, so there are multiple ways of relating those classes to one another. Okay, so what are those? One class to another class is one. I have my first class. Okay, I have my second class. So there are multiple ways of defining the relationship amongst them. Okay, so what are them? So one is dependency. Okay, so dependency says class 1, class 2. Class 1 is dependent with class 2. So I'll be just showing across with a dotted lines to it. Okay, whereas association. Okay, so whenever I say association, it's with a solid line which exists between class 1 and class 2. Okay, then comes generalization. Okay, generalization says wherein I have, this happens to be my one main class. Okay, and this happens to be my subclass there. Okay, for that particular subclass, so what do I say? Is that particular subclass is it's an inherent, it's a sub part of that main class called as base class there. Okay. Similarly, I have realization or as interfaces. Whenever you are going to show this, this is being shown across as this is my superclass, this is my subclass, and this is how and dotted line with an arrow mark towards it. Okay, is shown. Okay, this is your subclass, this is your superclass. This is how the relationships are shown across with respect to the classes, more than one class included then. Okay, so similarly here, mainly dependency, generalization, realization are a part of a work which you are looking across. Okay, so mainly with respect to association, we have again different types of associations involved. Okay.